Yesterday, we heard the Director of National Intelligence, James Clapper, at Congress saying that North Korea's nuclear effort is the top threat to the United States. What would you do to deal with that reclusive country?
I would get China to make that guy disappear in one form or another very quickly. And let me tell you, people say,
how do you make him disappear and assassinate him?
Let me just tell you, no. Well, you know, I've heard of worse things, frankly. I mean, this guy's a bad dude. And don't underestimate him. Any young guy can take over from his father with all those generals and everybody else that probably want the position. This is not somebody to be underestimated.
Tonight, Kim Jong-un could be one step closer to threatening America with a nuclear-tipped missile. The ballistic missiles his regime just test-fired landed within 200 miles of the coast of Japan. These were not Kim's most advanced missiles. But by launching at least four of them at once, experts say he's working toward a specific kind of threat.
They're putting together salvos of missiles that may be harder to defeat. And so three, four missiles going to the same place, maybe from different places, that's the kind of thing that's going to be a little bit harder, not impossible, but a little bit harder to defeat.
The missile test is viewed as Kim's warning in response to joint military exercises going on now between U.S. and South Korean forces. Kim views those drills as practice for an invasion of North Korea. The United States and South Korea deny this. Tonight, the Trump administration is calling his missile test a, quote, very serious threat, and not ruling out a military response, promising it's prepared to use, quote, the full range of capabilities. U.S. officials know Kim is ramping up his missile capabilities toward launching a long-range ballistic missile, one that could send a nuclear warhead to the continental United States.
It is a different animal to shoot one all the way to the United States, but they have in the last couple years been testing some solid fuel motors that when combined together can get you some pretty long legs to get there. But this is the kind of capability that folks are pretty antsy about them deciding to test.
U.S. officials and outside analysts say what's not clear is whether Kim's regime has adequately tested whether his nuclear-tipped missiles could survive re-entry into the atmosphere. There's a new report saying America has tried to disrupt Kim's missile program with cyber attacks. The New York Times reports that 3 years ago, President Obama ordered Pentagon officials to increase cyber strikes against North Korea's missile program, hoping to sabotage the launches. The Times reports soon after Obama's order, several North Korean rockets began to explode and veer off course. It's not clear if that was due to the cyber attacks, North Korea's own mistakes, or something else.
The alleged U.S. cyber program would be a good idea. The goal is to slow North Korea's development of deliverable nuclear weapons to buy time for potential changes in the North Korean political context.
The U.S. Navy SEALs are gearing up for regime change in North Korea. It looks like that the U.S., South Korea and Japan are about to start a major confrontation against North Korea. On the other side, North Korea has ordered its troops to prepare for full-scale war. To a large extent, the U.S. foreign policy has created this situation. There is a fair amount of escalation between the US, South Korea, Japan, and North Korea. In large part, that is because the US alliance holds large-scale military drills. However, North Korea's response is a particular concern to the alliance because of the increased missile launches which have landed extremely close to Japan. The US Special Operations Forces, including the unit that killed Osama bin Laden, will take part in the joint military drills in South Korea. They will practice the regime change of North Korean leadership in the case of a conflict. The Fall Edge exercise started March 1st and will run through the end of April. South Korea and Washington said that the joint military drills are purely defensive, but North Korea has denounced them as the military training for an invasion. In response to the alliance actions, Kim Jong-un has ordered the army to prepare for a full-scale war. Strategic patience is necessary in this situation. While the deployment regarding the provocative Chinese actions against the United States is no surprise, the question arises, when a crisis breaks out with the US alliance and North Korea, what role will China play? Will China come to the aid of North Korea? Donald Trump recently said that China is not doing nearly enough to curb the provocations from North Korea. North Korea's latest missile launch comes closer to Japanese land than ever before in our history. The ballistic missiles launched by North Korea landed in the closest proximity to Japanese land. I do not get that. If tensions are rising between two Koreas, why they are targeting Japan? Nearly at the same time, we had another drill by North Korea, which demonstrated the combat capability of the Hwangsong artillery units under simulated conditions of making preemptive strikes at ports and airfields in South Korea, where the US military hardware was stationed. We need to specifically address that. The test also helped to examine the operational features of the detonating devices of nuclear warheads mounted on the ballistic rockets at the designated altitude over the target area, which is a very concerning situation. The US military bases in Japan were targeted in the missile launch drill by North Korea. The missiles fired by North Korea towards Japan were part of an exercise targeting the US military bases there. It comes as the White House said that deployment of the advanced THAAD anti-missile defense system to South Korea will guard the country against the North Korea. The missile launch by North Korea into the Sea of Japan were a military drill carried out by an army unit commissioned with attacking the United States military bases in Japan. North Korean leader Kim Jong-un personally supervised the drill. In the drill were involved Hwangsong artillery units of the KPA Strategic Force, tasked to strike the bases of the US forces in Japan. In the hearts of an artilleryman, there was a burning desire to retaliate against the warmongers going ahead with their joint war exercises. The launch of four ballistic missiles by North Korea was preceded by threats of retaliation of the US-South Korea military drills. North Korea views the military exercises as a preparation of an attack on North Korea. Following the missile launch by North Korea, Trump pledged the full US support to Japan over the issue in a telephone conversation with Japanese Prime Minister Shinzo Abe. President Trump told the Japanese Prime Minister that the United States was with Japan 100%, and President Trump wanted his comments to be communicated to the Japanese people. The US President also reportedly asked Japanese people to trust him, as well as the United States, 100%.
North Korea's most recent missile launch is absolutely intolerable.
北朝鮮は国連決議を完全に遵守すべきです。
North Korea must fully comply with the relevant UN Security Council resolutions.
I just want everybody to understand and fully know that the United States of America stands behind Japan, its great ally, 100%. Thank you.
Japan considers first strike options against North Korea. The U.S. Defense Department confirmed that North Korea carried out multiple launches of medium-range ballistic missiles. Out of four missiles, three landed 300 to 350 kilometers or 200 miles from Akita Island. One missile landed about 200 kilometers or around 124 miles from the Japan's island, the closest proximity to Japan in the history of North Korea's missile launches. Japanese Defense Minister Tomomi Inada said that her country was not excluding any response measures within the international legal framework in connection with the missile launches. China urges North Korea to halt nuclear and missile tests to prevent head-on collision against the United States. China has called on North Korea to suspend its nuclear and missile activities to avoid a head-on collision against the United States and South Korea. In exchange, Washington and South Korea should halt the military drills. To defuse the looming crisis on the Korean Peninsula, China proposes that, as a first step, North Korea may suspend its nuclear and missile activities in exchange for the halt of the large-scale military drills by US and South Korea. When we have North Korea firing four ballistic missiles, we have South Korea together with the United States launching large-scale military drills. The two sides are like two accelerating trains coming towards each other, with neither side willing to give way or stop. The question is, are the two sides really ready for head-on collision? To flash the red light and apply the brakes on both trains? Unfortunately, it seems that it is too late. The military war games were a major cause of escalation of tension that is ready to turn into actual war. Japan said that the country were considering to deploy THAAD missile defense system on its land as well. If Japan chooses to deploy THAAD, that means Japan will receive a three-stage interceptor system to secure its borders, able to intercept missiles inside or outside the Earth's atmosphere. Do you still think that the deployment of THAAD is to stop North Korea? It is the worst time for South Korea because of President Park's impeachment and the uncertainty and deterioration in the security situation on the Korean Peninsula. This situation it is identical to what has happened in Ukraine when the same hidden power has overthrown the president of Ukraine. Do you remember what happened immediately after the impeachment of the president of Ukraine? The conflict started in Ukraine, which continues to this day and is ready to evolve into a big confrontation against Russia any moment now. That is the plan of the hidden hand. Just ask this question: what is the real agenda of the impeachment of the president of South Korea? Especially at the moment when we have the biggest NATO buildup in Europe and WW3 is about to start in the South China Sea region. Well, to me it is obvious that we have the same hand pulling the strings in Ukraine and now on Korean Peninsula and in the South China Sea. Look, just few months ago, the president of South Korea was against the missile defense system installation. What we have now? The president was removed from power, and we have the missile defense system which is being installed in the South Korea. Just raise the following question: what is the next step of the hidden hand?